I now pronounce you
married.
Yes, to a toast, yeah.
Well, I have a toast. To Rebecca and what's her name? Susan. Rebecca was my first love. And so this is my farewell toast. I bid you farewell. Don't forget I taught her everything she knows.
I thank you.
Best of luck, Becca. Susan. And, you know, we'll see. 6 months from now.
I'm so excited.
That's nice.
See you later, buddy.
Whoa. Nice one.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I found out Susan's pregnant, and they're going to name the godparent tonight. I think it's going to be me.
Yeah, I agree. If they want the baby to have fashion advice from someone.
To love.
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 Cheers.
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 You guys, Susan and I would just like to. My wife. We would just like to thank you guys for being here. I mean, this is what it's all about. I mean, you're a family.
Also, just being here on what was a moment's notice.
Because of Proposition 8 looming over our heads and the family just being all up in our business.
And even though it probably won't pass, but we just thought that we should do it.
Just in case. So thank you.
Thank you. And also to our amazing Paul, who pretty much orchestrated this whole evening. So thank you. Insisted to take care of every little detail. You know, Paul.
Paul.
And Paul, this is for you from us.
Cookies.
Wow. Okay. Oh, what the heck. Oh my God. Ladies. I've just been asked to be this glorious couple's first child's godparent.
Who is gonna make the worst godparent ever?
Yes, he's not going to be very good at all. You know, Paul, I think you are going to make the best godparent ever. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Ladies are the most faithful. Ladies and seahorses are the most faithful. Is that a girl?
Do you know that guy? Don't look.
You need to calm down. Have some fun. Are you drinking? Drink more.
Oh, for God's sakes, just ask him out. What are you taking now?
Terry thought he was going to be named a godparent.
Oh, you are kidding me. I told Susan not to tell anybody, especially Terry, because he can't keep a secret. Is he hurt? You're terrible. Here, it's an early birthday present. Yeah.
Rebecca. Thank you.
Her 10th farewell performance.
Yeah. Yeah, you know what? You should ask Jim to go. I know he's a complete Miss Piggy Bee freak, too. I think you guys would really hit it off. You should ask him. Paul, grow some big ones and go ask him out.
You know I can't be in a relationship right now. My work takes up all of my time. And keeping up with this house. And I'm way too set in my ways, and I think I'm allergic to Lycra.
There's a pussy on this couch, and it ain't me.
Great speech.
Oh no, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Don't worry.
Yeah. Where did you go?
Thank you.
Yes, no problem.
Thank you. Thank you.
Drop that. Yes.
At least it wasn't red wine.
I don't allow red wine in the house. Stains.
Well, I just love, love, love your home. It kind of reminds me of Tomorrowland.
That's the best compliment ever. I loved your ceremony.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So, Paul, Rebecca tells me you haven't had a relationship since high school. How does that make you feel?
Just fine.
Well, it was great to finally meet you, Paul. Okay. Here's my card. Call me anytime. Rebecca put me up to this.
Thank you. I have tickets.
Oh, wow, that's great. I'm actually producing the event. Well, I just wanted to come by and say hi before I left. You know, Rebecca says so much great things about you. She really loves you, which means you must not be that bad because she's great. Well, I guess I'll see you around.
Great place.
Yeah, the,
He didn't hear you say that.